Earlier this year at the State of the Nation speech, I spoke of wanting to set up what we described as army-style correction courses. So they were meant to be as part of a sentence that the youth court could hand out to young offenders who the chief youth court judge has described as the 1,000 most serious young offenders, which have the potential to be unexploded human time bombs. The idea behind the sort of facilities or sort of programs was really going to be potentially a 3-month residential course, setting out structure and discipline, boundaries, and then moving beyond there, obviously a full 12-month course, which would include everything from literacy and numeracy training, drug and alcohol rehabilitation courses and the likes. Today we've visited one of those that's in operation, Advanced Training Corp, and they're doing a great job. They're on the ground in 6 locations. They are taking about 100 or 200 young people a year who they're taking right through a full program. It's not residential, but it is giving them great skills training in both physical education, but also working on those literacy and numeracy skills. And having fantastic success. A lot of their people going on to the military, to the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, and the police force. It's exactly the sort of example that we're talking about. We think that the fact that we're sitting around with so many young people in youth gangs, going off the rails in all sorts of different ways, and yet there's so limited options available for them is not the right way for this country. And if we become the government in about 5 weeks' time, we'll be increasing substantially the funding in this area. I'm not going to have young people sitting around in youth gangs. I am going to make sure that they're directed into these kinds of training programs, and that they have an opportunity and a hope, some hope for the future, and meanwhile making our streets safer. So it was great to go out and see that practical course operating. It's been very successful. There are many others operating like that around the country, but they're underfunded and simply not taking enough of our young people for my liking.
Make sure the kids are drug free, but also with structure and discipline and a sense of purpose that they can go on later on to, you know, hopefully get a job, teaching in the Army, Navy, Air Force, whatever it might be. The second thing is this is picking up a lot of young people that aren't necessarily coming out of the youth corps, they're coming for a variety of different referrals, whatever the wins, whatever. And that's exactly where we want to take the program as well. So under us, we'd be expanding this kind of sort of
centre. Because obviously a lot of the kids, the standard school environment may not be suited
too
well.
That's right.
So these models, you think they would go well?
Well, they're working very well. I mean, it's quite remarkable. You think that a lot of these kids have dropped out of school, and yet their attendance rates are great. They're achieving NCEA level 1, they're achieving it at a high level, staying drug and alcohol. We're flexible about how the program might work on the training side, as long as it fits in with what we think is appropriate, which is it's got to set boundaries, there has to be structure to it, and it's got to instill the discipline that youngsters who are otherwise going off the rails need to ensure that they can see opportunities for their lives. And that's what's happening here. The course is simply giving a vehicle for giving them the opportunity to maximise their life.